Hey guys, welcome to another video of H2 Media Vlogs. In today's video, we are going to be reviewing the Xeon Smooth 4 gimbal. Let's get right into today's video. Before we actually get into the video, I want you guys to first see how the gimbal was packaged in this really nice foam casing. However, that case is not a permanent case. It's not very rigid. I would say that it would only last you maybe temporary until you actually get a perfect or nice casing for your gimbal. But first, here's the unboxing. That was the unboxing of the gimbal. The gimbal does come in this really cool foam case. Like I said, it wouldn't last you too long, but it's a temporary case until you get yourself a nice casing for the gimbal. But I would never recommend you guys to ever put it loose in a bag, because the motors on the gimbal is really delicate and a small knock and stuff could damage the motors. Okay, so before we actually test out the gimbal and test out all its features and modes, here's a few details of the gimbal. So it has a quarter inch tripod mount at the bottom. It's a screw mount where you can mount any tripod to it, which is really cool. However, it does come with its own tripod, so I suggest you use its own tripod, especially when balancing the gimbal and setting it down while shooting. It comes with a 12-hour battery life. You are also able to charge your phone from the gimbal from a little adapter cord that you can buy online. And it's really cool just to get that smaller adapter cord, because while you're on a shoot, it's like basically a power bank. You can charge your phone and shoot. It's really cool. It is a USB Type-C. It also has a lot of features like 180 panels, vertigo, three by three panel, dynamic mode. I don't even know how that works, but I tried it. It doesn't really seem to work on Android, which is my next topic, and that is the downfalls of having the app. So the app is a requirement for your gimbal to work smoothly and to get all the crazy shots that you want to operate the gimbal from your phone. So basically, you're operating the gimbal by its controls, which everything is really put out on the handle, which is awesome. A lot of gimbals, you have to operate most of the things from the screen, and I really do not like that, because you are interfering with the screen and the motor sometimes can get a bit shaky as you're moving and trying to get that cool shot. However, on the Xeon, everything is built on the handle, so as you're walking, it makes everything so much easier when shooting, because you can just have access to everything on the handle. Actually, like a really cool feature, having everything on the handle, you just get to have more freedom when shooting outdoors. However, I must say that it actually comes with a notice in the box telling you that it doesn't really work so well on Android, which is quite a downfall, because a lot of people nowadays have Android and some people have iOS, but it's like the app on the Android phone for some reason does work too well. I must say that having this gimbal for the last, I think, a month now, I've really learned most of its features and learned the gimbal, but like, I feel that I'm restricted because I use an Android phone and not the iOS, and it just puts you off when you are really shooting. And I feel that they should have had a better creation of the app on the Android phone, if that makes sense. Okay, so that's the basic like details of having it on the app. It's all the downfalls on the app, but I must say that The way you operate Gimbal is a bit of a disappointment from its previous iterations, because having no joystick on the gimbal really makes it hard to get some moving shots, like getting skyscrapers and stuff, because you can't really move it. Sometimes if you want to get a top shot moving it down like that, you can't. You have to actually move the gimbal physically, which is not so cool. I feel that they should have put a joystick on there to make it much more operational at shoots, because sometimes you have it on the monopod, and if you can buy an extender to have it make it work off the monopod so you can just hold it and somebody can control the movements, it will be really cool. I really feel that if they come up with a Zhiyun Smooth 5, these features should be a big part of that. Okay, so it does come with a really cool lot of features. Let's test out those features. Okay, so one of the features is the time-lapse mode, which works personally awesome. I've tried it a few times and it really works well. So all you have to do is you have to go into the camera mode, click onto the camera modes, and then go to camera, then you'll find all of these features there. Time-lapse mode, you have to basically put a start point and an end point, and you can even get moving time-lapses, which is awesome. Vertigo effects, same thing, you need to also put a start, end point, fill in a few details on the screen, and then it basically semi-automatic. All you have to do is just move it and voila, you get yourself a really cool vertigo. There is also the 3x3 panoramic mode and the 180 panoramic mode. The 180 seemed to work perfect, but for some reason the 3x3 panoramic mode wasn't in my favor at all on the Android. I was at Kialami a few weeks ago shooting a video for them, and it was really terrible when I tried to get the 3x3 panoramic mode to work. For some reason on Android, the gimbal spins around and it tries to get it from the back part, but like it jams, it just doesn't work at all. I've never used it ever again. Most of the time I do use the gimbal manually, and I can say it works 100% normal. Everything is perfect. But just if you want to take over the gimbal and really use all its features, just remember on Android it's not really going to work for you, which is quite a downfall. Okay, so that was actually the review of the gimbal. I actually tried to break it down really small and try to make this thing as quick as possible, because there are millions of reviews of this Zhiyun Smooth 4 everywhere on YouTube. You guys can just go search it up and get a detailed review, even from Zhiyun Tech. So yeah. If you guys want to check out detailed reviews in them, you guys can go check that out. I just wanted to put most of the pros and cons and a few things that they could have added, which they didn't, and a few things that they removed, which they also should not have done. So, yeah, if you guys want more videos about the Zhiyun Smooth 4, leave a like to the video and explain exactly what you want in the comments down below. It makes it really easier when we make videos. And also, sorry for not uploading for a long time. I've been really trying to make this video work. I've been learning the gimbal, learning its operational features, and it's really cool. Yeah, that is the review of the Zhiyun Smooth 4. I will see you guys in another video. Peace.